Hello students, today we are going to start our second biology session. In our first biology session, we had discussed about the structure and function of the leaves. There we have studied the main functions of leaf, mainly photosynthesis, transpiration, gaseous exchange. Apart from these important functions, in some plants, leaves are modified to perform some special functions to adjust with its own environment. In this topic, first we will discuss about leaf dendril. In some weak-stemmed plants, you can see that at the tip of leaf there is a spring-like structure that is actually named leaf dendril. Actually, in the weak-stemmed plant, they by themselves can't grow up. So for them, leaf dendril mainly give them support to coil around some object and help the plants to climb up. Here you can see, this is the leaf dendril. The terminal leaflets are modified in the coiled spring-like structure. That is leaf dendril, and these leaf dendrils mainly help the plant to climb up on some support. Example is sweet pea. Next we will proceed to the leaf spine. In some plants, leaves are modified to some hard pointed objects. They are known as leaf spines. Actually, these leaf spines are mainly found in desert plants or xerophytes. You all know that in the deserts, the climate is mainly dry and the soil contains very less amount of water. So how much water the plants absorb, they want to conserve it. So to check the water loss or to prevent the transpiration, the leaves are modified to the spines. And the spines are also helpful for protecting the plant from grazing animals. Here you can see that the spines, these are spines, the hard pointed objects, and these are mainly found in the xerophytic plants like cactus, opuntia, and these spines mainly check transpiration or to prevent the water loss from the plants. This is the detailed diagram of the opuntia, a desert plant. Next, we will proceed to the phyllode. In our previous session, we had discussed about leaf stalk or leaf petiole. What is it? It is the stalk by which leaf lamina is attached to the stem. In some plants, this leaf petiole is expanded and become leaf-like structure, that is flat green photosynthetic structure. Here in this diagram you can see, this is the normal leaf and this is the petiole, actually modified petiole. You can't differentiate it from the leaf because it is same like leaf, flat green and photosynthetic. So what is the function of this phyllode? Function of the phyllode is to reduce the water loss, thus conserve water. Next we will proceed to the hook, leaf hook. In some plants like bignonia, terminal leaflets are modified to the hook-like structure. This hook-like structure actually gives support to the plant to climb up. Here you can see this terminal leaflets, three leaflets mainly, modified into three curved and pointed hook-like structure which looks like cat's nail, and it helps the plant to give the support for climbing. Example is bignonia. In this diagram also you can see these all are the hooks. Next is scale leaves. What is scale leaves? These are mainly thin or thick, dry, non-photosynthetic leaves. Example is ginger. In this picture you can see the ginger. Everybody, you are quite known to this structure. The brown colored these leaves are mainly scale leaves. The function of these scale leaves is to protect the buds. Here is the bud, and these all brownish structures are known as scale leaves. These are non-photosynthetic, as because these are non-green. Next, we will proceed to our topic, insectivorous plants. From the name only, you can understand that insectivorous plants feed on insects. So here one question may arise that why these insectivorous plants eat insects? Actually, these plants are growing in that type of soil where the nitrogen quantity is very less. And this nitrogen is a very essential component of protein molecule, which is required for the plant growth. So to fulfill the demand of nitrogen, these plants trap and digest the insects to get the protein, thus to grow properly. So here we will mainly discuss three types of insectivorous plants. First is pitcher plant or Nepenthes. Here in this picture you can see the structure or diagram of the pitcher plant. In this plants, the leaf lamina is modified to this pitcher like structure which captures the insects, and this lid like structure which covers this pitcher is mainly leaf apex, that is the tip of the leaf, is modified to this lid like structure, and this full structure is hanged by this long petiole. Insects are getting attracted to this structure by the smell of nectar secreted by this pitcher, and the sides of the pitcher is too slippery that when insects come in contact with this structure, they directly fall to this groove of the pitcher where the digestive juice is there. So when the insects fall in this groove, the digestive juice help to digest the insect's body and release the nitrogen, which is essential for the plant's growth. Next, we will proceed to the next insectivorous plant, that is bladderwort or Utricularia. Here you can see that the leaf is modified to the sac-like structure. So many sac-like structures you can see here in this diagram. These all are known as bladders. This bladder-like structure
contains an opening. You can see this, all openings which can be closed. So when insects enters to this opening closed, and the insects go inside the sac, then digestive juice digests the insect. Next is venous flytrap. Here the leaf lamina is divided into two parts. This is one part, this is second part. These two parts are joined by this midrib, or you can say that hinged by midrib. And when the insects come in contact with this structure, they are getting interlocked by this marginal teeth, which prevent the escaping of the insect from this structure. These are actually known as marginal teeth. Here you can see it helps this marginal teeth actually, after interlocking, prevent the escaping of the insect. Next, we will proceed to the vegetative propagation. In our previous session also, little bit we have discussed about this topic. Vegetative propagation is the production of new plants from the vegetative part of the plants, like roots, stem, leaves. Here is leaf. In some plants, leaves contain buds. These are known as epiphyllous buds. So here in this diagram you can see that from the notches of the leaf margin, buds can grow. What is that notches? This is the V-cut shape. This is known as notches. And from these notches of the leaf margin, buds can grow. After that, when the buds get detached from the leaf and placed in the soil, they can form new plant with roots and small leaves. So this is the vegetative propagation process. So by that topic, we are ending the first chapter, that is the leaf. In our next session, we will discuss about the next topic or next chapter. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.